students, I am Safiya, your science teacher. Today we are going to continue the topic playing with magnets. The next topic or the next activity which we are going to do is we are going to find out the directions by using a magnet. We are going to use bar magnet to find the directions. So our activity is finding directions by using bar magnet or with the help of bar magnet. So as it is activity, you have to follow the format what it is. You have to first find out what is the aim of this activity to find out the directions with the help of a bar magnet. Then the materials required for this will be bar magnet, okay, main thing, and we need a stand and a thread. So we are going to take a stand and with an iron rod. Like this, you have to tie a bar magnet. As we know, bar magnet has two poles, it is north pole and the south pole. And you have to tie the thread exactly at the center of a bar magnet. For example, if it is a magnet, then this will be north pole, this is the south pole. So you have to tie the thread exactly at the center and suspend this bar magnet. You are tying the thread and leaving it freely here. You are suspending a bar magnet. Okay. Now, what you have to do? You have to see at what direction this is going to stop after tying it with a thread. Now leave this bar magnet, okay? Now disturb the bar magnet. You have to rotate the bar magnet or you have to disturb the bar magnet. When you disturb the bar magnet, that means the magnet will be moving, right? So after some time, you have to observe this magnet will stop moving. That means magnet will come to a rest position. So at that time, you have to observe what are the directions of that bar magnet. After disturbing, whether they came to same directions or not. For example, north is this side and south is this side, right? So I am going to mark with a color pen. I am using a blue color pen here to mark south pole. Okay, so I have marked south pole. This is first observation which I got. Now after some time, again you disturb the bar magnet. Again you are going to disturb the bar magnet. And now disturb, okay? So you have rotated it, so the bar magnet is moving. So again it will come to rest. So now you have to observe whether colored portion, where it is going to come to rest, whether this side or that side. You'll observe same again this side. That means by this activity you'll understand that a suspended bar magnet comes to rest at north and south direction. A freely suspended bar magnet always comes to rest at north and south direction. So this property of magnet is called as directional property. This property of magnet is called as directional property. This property can be seen only in magnets. So whenever you disturb a magnet, it will come to rest in north and south direction. So this type of property of magnets is called as directional property, and that means these magnets are helpful in you showing the directions. As I said, we can find out the directions by using magnet. So this property is used in making magnetic compass. Magnetic compass is used to know the directions. This is used by the army people, by the soldiers, army people, and the people mountaineers who will climb the mountains, those are mountaineers, airplanes, ships, etc. This is a device. Okay, the device is like this. Okay, it will be circular in shape and it has markings here, north, south, like this. The markings will be, and there will be a needle pivoted here. Needle will be present here, and that needle, one side of it will be colored, different color. This side is also it will be colored, but one side of it is colored. Why it is colored? To show the north direction. That means whenever any person is moving to unknown place, that they should know the directions. So to know the directions, they use this magnetic compass. And this magnetic compass, whenever it shows north direction, this colored one will come and stop near the north direction. This is how the directional property of magnets is used. In between north and south, you can observe east-west directions also. Those can also be seen by using this magnetic compass. You should not place magnetic compass and the magnets close to each other because it may show the wrong directions. And next which we are going to learn is the attraction and repulsion. Attraction and repulsion. So to do this, you have to use two bar magnets. We are going to use two bar magnets. See, one bar magnet I have taken, one more bar magnet I am going to take. You observe these bar magnets and the poles of the bar magnets. This side is the south pole, this is the north one. Whereas for the second magnet, this is the north and this is the south pole. Now, when you put these bar magnets in this situation, you will observe that both these magnets will repel. They don't want to come close to each other. They will move against each other because both the poles are same. These are like poles. Like poles mean same poles, north and north pole. So, like poles will repel. Now, the second condition is this. Again, you are going to take the magnets, north, south. South and north. See here, we have taken the magnets and kept in this position. North this side, south this side. Here south this side and north this side. What you will observe here? Do you find any attraction here? No. Again, as these two are like poles, you will observe, they'll show repulsion. That means these two magnets will go against each other. They'll be moving far away from each other because these two are like poles. Now, again you have to take the magnets. First magnet we have taken and the second magnet I am going to take here. And the poles are like this. See here, this is south pole, north pole, south and north pole. Now what do you think? Are these like poles? Are these having same, what do you think? Are these like poles? No, these are unlike poles. See, here it is north pole, here it is south pole. As these are unlike poles, you will observe here attraction. Both the magnets will get attracted to each other. They will get attracted and they will join with each other. So that is because these are unlike poles. In these first two situations, you have seen where like poles are present. Here, the repulsion will take place. But in the third situation, you will observe as these are unlike poles, attraction has been taken place. Next activity which we are going to do is, we are going to make our own magnet. How to make our own magnet? For that, you have to take one magnetic material. Magnetic material in the sense, we can take iron nail. So, I am going to take iron nail and a bar magnet. So, you before starting this activity, you have to see this iron nail is not attracting any of the other objects. It is not attracting any clips or safety pins. So that means this is completely only iron nail without any magnetism. Now, take one bar magnet. For example, this is north side, This is the south side of the magnet. Now what we have to do, we have to strike this nail with the bar magnet. How many times you have to strike? 20 to 30 times. But there is a condition which you have to follow. So what you have to do when you are, for example, this north side you are going to strike, right? So this north side only, continuously 30 times you have to strike with north side only. You have to start from north side only. You have to strike with this side only. That means you have to start striking with the north pole. One strike, how you have to do? North pole. Okay, this is your iron nail. So, north side, here. We have started striking north. So, one stroke. We should not lift the magnet. It should be going, we are going on striking it with the same direction without, what? You should strike the iron nail with the help of magnet in this position only. You should not lift the magnet. So first stroke is no more to do some like this. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In this way you have to completely strike for 20 to 30 minutes. And after 20 to 30 times, after striking for 20 to 30 times, we'll observe this nail will get some magnetic property. So now take out the bar magnet and use this bar and this nail to find out whether this nail is behaving as a magnet or not. What you do, bring this bar magnet near this end and it will be, so here we got, as we have used this, so what will happen here, you will observe these two poles will get attracted. That means whether what pole it, this tail of the nail is behaving, it is behaving as a south pole. That means this side of the nail is south pole, tail of the nail is south pole. Now bring this bar magnet and put the south pole this side and this side will be the north pole. Again you will see attraction. So in this way you have to find out whether your nail is working properly or not, whether it has become magnet or not. If you do this strikes properly for 20 to 30 times, then you will observe that obviously your nail will change as a magnet. In this way you can make your own magnet. Next activity is making our own magnetic compass. So what is our next activity? To make our own magnetic compass. In the last activity, we have made our own magnet. Now we are going to make our own magnetic compass. So as we know, we need a needle here, which behaves as a magnet. So what we are going to take? We are going to take the same nail which we have magnetized. So as in this activity, what you have to follow? You have to follow the format like, first will be the aim. What is aim? To make our own magnetic compass. Materials required for this will be the glass tumbler and magnetized needle or a nail, magnetized nail, cork, water, tape, detergent. Okay, these are the materials required. Now procedure is what, you have to take a glass tumbler. Okay, fill it with the water. In this you are going to add some detergent solution. This will become detergent solution. Okay, as you are adding detergent here, it will become detergent solution. Now take one cork, cut it in the shape of circle. Okay, you have to cut the shape of, take a cork and cut it in the circular shape. And later on you have to fix a needle onto it. We have taken iron nail, right? So that iron nail should be placed on the cork. For example, if it is my cork, if my hand, you assume that my hand is a cork. So you are going to put this iron nail on it, which is already magnetized. This side is behaving as the north and this is behaving as the south. This part is north, this is the south. So I am going to place it on the cork. But as it will move, so you have to fix this. For fixing this, you are going to tape this needle with the cork. Okay, you are keeping the tape here so that it cannot move. So now place this cork in the glass of water in this way, like this, north pole and south pole. This is north, this is the south. Okay, the head part is north and the tail part is south as we have seen. Now, keep this apparatus in any position. That means directions. Already when you are moving, cork will be moving. Right, it will be floating freely in the air. It will be floating. Keep this apparatus in any position. Okay, in any direction, at any place at your home. And this cork will be floating because we have added detergent solution into the water. So now we will observe that even though this cork is moving, it will come to rest always in north and south direction. This nail will come to rest in north and south direction always. If this needle or the nail is coming in north and south direction, rest. If this nail is coming in rest always in north and south direction, that means this apparatus is behaving as a magnetic compass. Next one is magnetic induction. So what is magnetic induction? So to know this magnetic induction, you have to take a magnet. Same, we are going to take bar magnet, two poles of the magnet. And now bring bar magnet we have taken, then safety pin we have to take, and then Allen. It is used for putting the documents, and also same thing we are going to use here. So these three things we are going to take. Now what you do, bring this safety pin near this magnet. What will happen, as it is made up of iron, this will get attracted, right? So what about this? These two things got attracted. Now remove this magnet and now try to put this pin near the safety pin. What you observe? Do you observe any attraction between these two? No, you can't find any attraction. Okay. Now once again, what you have to do? Put this safety pin near this bar magnet. For example, we have kept this near bar magnet. The safety pin got attracted. Now you bring this Allen near the safety pin. You'll observe this Allen will get attracted towards the safety pin. That is because this magnet is giving the magnetic property to the safety pin. So as it is inducing property to the safety pin is behaving as a magnet. Now, remove this bar magnet. This bar magnet and safety pin should not be in contact. Then also you'll observe that safety pin is able to attract this Allen because the magnetic property of the magnet has been influenced this safety pin, and as a result safety pin is behaving as a magnet. After some time the safety pin will behave as a magnet and it will attract all the magnetic materials. This is called as magnetic induction. Magnetic property possessed by a magnetic material when it is near to the magnet is called as magnetic induction. So students, this is the end of your lesson, playing with magnets. Go through the videos thoroughly and properly and do the homework which I am giving you regularly.